शंकराचार्य मध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति श्रुति पुराणानामालयं तरुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनि व्योमवद्व्याप्तिनि दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः ॐ यो ब्रह्माणुजाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः आम्नायान्तिक संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दकरम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। ओके, सो वी सॉ देर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ जन्मास पॉसिबल, जरायुज, अंडज, स्वेदज एंड उद्भिज्ज। उद्विद देर कंपेयर टू दिस उद्विज्ज अमोंग दीज चतुर्विध देहेशु स्वेदज उद्भिज्जयोः स्त्री पुं व्यक्ति संयोगम विना उत्पत्ति दर्शनात्। दैट्स व्हाट वी सॉ इन टू केसेस देर इज उत्पत्ति, जीव उत्पत्ति मीनिंग जन्म इन अ शरीर विदाउट द पुरुष एंड स्त्री संयोग इन स्वेदज एंड उद्भिज्ज काइंड ऑफ उत्पत्ति वी सी देर इज नो स्त्री पुरुष संयोग इंडिविजुअल व्यक्ति संयोग एंड विदाउट दैट वी सी देर फॉर दर्शन च वॉट दी पंचम आहुति दैट इज दैट विच इज क्लेम्ड बाय द पूर्व पक्षी एज नेसेसरी फॉर उत्पत्ति ऑफ ऑल जीवास दैट काइंड ऑफ एन आइडिया इज रिफ्यूटेड देयर बाय पापीज needing to have chandraloka vasa to have panchama ahuti that is also refuted further nanu trini eva bijani bhavanti andajam jivajam udbijjam iti sharira traividya shravanat katam chaturvidyam ityatah now purvapakshi raises a prasangika prashna he says you are talking about four types of jivajanmas but really there are only three because what does the shruti vakya say trini eva bijani bhavanti the shruti says that there are three types of bijas in the sense that there are three types of janmas jiva janmas have to be three types which are those andajam which has been mentioned in the vritti earlier in under darshanachya then jivajam jivajam should be taken as what jarayuja born from jiva meaning born from the womb there that's the meaning there then udbijjam meaning the same one that we saw earlier there is udbijja so this svedaja is not included by the shruti vakya quoted by the purvapakshi so nanu triniyo bijani bhavanti andajam jivajam udbijjam iti sharira traividya shravanat so I think udbid yesterday I said this dakara So it's a jakara only. There is no dakara. Udbijja ja is there because jani pradurbhave that dhatu in samasa has given this udbijja. I think I mentioned as dakara. That is wrong. Iti sharira traividya shravanat. So there are only three types of shariras for jiva. There is no fourth called svedaja. Katham chaturvidya mityata ah. So how can you say there are four types of shariras? That is not true. टू दैट भगवान सूत्रकार से तृतीय शब्दावरोध संशोकजस्य तृतीय शब्दावरोध संशोकजस्य सो द थर्ड विच इज व्हाट दिस स्वेदज दैट इज इंक्लूडेड तृतीय शब्देन उद्भिज्य दैट उद्भिज्य शब्देन तृतीय शब्देन उद्भिज्य शब्देन व्हाट अवरोधः अवरोध मीन संग्रहः सो तृतीय शब्दावरोध संशोकजस्य दैट इज ए पदच्छेद इन द सूत्र देयर इज नथिंग एल्स टू डू इट इज ऑलरेडी छिन्न सो अवरोध इज संग्रह संग्रह मीन्स द थर्ड sorry, not Svedaja, but here Udbhijja, here, not the earlier part there, but the Tritiya here, Jeev, what has been said, Andajam, Jeevaja and Udbhijja. There in Udbhijja, Tritiya Shabdena, Udbhijjena, Udbhijja Shabdena, Avarodaha, meaning Sangraha, Kasya, Samshoka, Jasyapi. Samshoka is Sveda. So samshoka jasya means sveda jasya. How does samshoka mean sweat there? Samyak shoka, so shoka in heat, in tapa, there is shoka. And thereby there is perspiration and that is sveda. So sveda jaya samshoka jaya. This is how the meaning can be taken. So sveda jaya is also included. Samshoka jasya, sveda jasya, sangraha, avarodha. कुत्र तृतीय शब्दे सो तृतीय शब्दे न और शब्दे इट्सेल्फ वी कैन टेक विद दैट और तृतीय इज बेटर तृतीय शब्दे न संशोकजस्य अवरोधः द स्वेदज इज आल्सो मेंट बाय तृतीय शब्द मीनिंग उद्भिज्ज शब्द बिकॉज विच विल बी एक्सप्लेन फर्दर इन दी वृत्ति विल सी देयर श्रुतौ आंडजम जीवजम उद्भिज्जम इत्यत्र तृतीय शब्देन उद्भिज्ज शब्देन अवरोधः संग्रह कस्य संशोकस्य स्वेदजस्य सो वन दैट इज बॉर्न फ्रॉम स्वेट दैट काइंड ऑफ अ शरीर अटेन्ड बाय द जीवा इज आल्सो इंक्लूडेड व्हेन यू से दैट द शरीर इज बॉर्न मीनिंग द जीवा इज बॉर्न इन टू अ शरीर हाउ बाय ब्रेकिंग द ग्राउंड उद्भिज्ज बाय ब्रेकिंग समथिंग सो देयर इन द उद्भिज्ज Breaking the ground will give the meaning of the plants and the trees basically. Plants which grow up to be trees. So that is the jiva taking the form of the sharira of the vriksha. That is the meaning we have taken with the tritiya shabda udbhijja. So ityatra tritiya shabdena. In the shruti andajam jivajam udbhijjam. Born of the egg. Born from jiva meaning from the womb. And then udbhijja meaning born breaking something ityatra tritiya shabdena udbhijja shabdena through that what is also included sangraha avarodha samshoka jasya sveda jasya one that is born from samshoka or born from sveda so vrikshadi is very clear this is what the purvapakshi is saying there is no svedaja because vriksha is meant by udbhijja so vrikshadikam prithvim udbhijja jayate so udbhijja means breaking something what is it breaking prithvi Having broken the prithvi, vriksha is born. Plants and trees, vrikshadikam, the grass or you know saplings, ankura ityadi, or you know even the small crops which do not grow up to be trees. So those are also included with the adipada. Vrikshadikam prithvim udbhidya jayate. Svedajam tu जलम उद्भिद्य इति उभयोः अवयवार्थत्व अविशेषात्तेन अस्य संग्रह कृतः हाउ इज दिस अवरोध और संग्रह पॉसिबल विद द उद्भिज्य शब्द हाउ कैन यू इंक्लूड हाउ कैन यू हैव संग्रह ऑफ संशोकज और स्वेदज देयर द सिद्धांति से स्वेदजम तु जलम उद्भिद्य So, udbhijya means that which breaks something and comes out. So, there if you look at it, it breaks the water body and comes out. With svedaja, those who are born of sweat, literally, the sweat is water there, jala. So, jalam udbhijya will be included in udbhijya. So, udbhijya, it includes that because vyutpatti arthaka, you can take that and then the yogika artha will give you there. Avayava artha is yogika artha. Avayava arthatva avishesha. There is no difference in the derived meaning for the vrikshas by taking derived meaning of a udbhija sabda and taking the meaning as svedaja also by yogika vyutpatti of udbhija. So udbhija means what? That which has broken something. So whether it is prithvi or jala, It is irrelevant. You can supply either एंड देयर बाय अवयव अर्थ और यौगिक अर्थ द डिराइव्ड मीनिंग इज सेम फॉर बोथ स्वेदज एज वेल एज दी उद्भिज वृक्षादि. सो वृक्षादि एज वेल एज दी स्वेदज हैव द सेम डेरिवेटिव मीनिंग देर फोर जलम उद्भिज्य इति उभयो अवयवार्थत्व अविशेषात. अवयवार्थ मीनिंग दि दि पार्ट्स पार्ट्स आर प्रकृति एंड प्रत्यय. सो प्रकृति एंड प्रत्यय इफ यू लुक एट इट यू हैव दिस और इन समास इन समास वॉट यू हैव यू हैव जी ज ज ज इज जनी प्रादुर्भाव दैट इज धातु देर एंड विथ ड प्रत्यय प्राप्त. सो डित्व सामर्थ्यात टेर लोपः. सो टी देयर इज अ टी टेक्निकलिटी एज टू जन इन दी जन धातु अन एनीथिंग दैट स्टार्ट्स विद द लास्ट वोवेल ऑल सेट ऑफ अक्षराज आर कॉल्ड एज टी इन दी पाणिनीय सूत्र. सो द टी इन जन धातु इज अन. सो दैट अन अंडर गोज लोप इट गोज अवे बिकॉज ऑफ ड प्रत्यय. ड प्रत्यय डकारा इज एन इथलेटर तस्य लोप दैट ऑल्सो गोज अवे. अ इज द कंटेंट. सो अ इज एडेड टू जन. जन प्लस ड विल यू जन प्लस अ एंड बिकॉज इट इज अ डिथ प्रत्यय डकारा इज एडेड टू मेक अ रूल दैट इज वन ऑफ द रूल्स इज वॉट दी टी विल ऑफ दी अंग मीनिंग दी प्रकृति और टू विच इट इज एडेड दैट विल गो अवे एंड टी हैपन्स टू बी अन. सो अन विल गो अवे एंड जकार विल रिमेन ऑफ दी जन धातु. देन जकार प्लस अ ऑफ दी प्रत्यय विल गिव ज एंड दिस इज पॉसिबल ओनली विथ वॉट एज अ समास विथ वॉट समथिंग इज prior to that. So there utpurvaka bhid this bhid so udbhijya or what will get you will get udbhija. Udbhija is what you will get there. Udbhijya sorry udbhijya is what you will get because what I was mentioning there I think yesterday what I said there where is that here udbhijyayoho. So here if you look at this udbhijyayoho what I said this sandhi is by jakara the dakara has become jakara. So I think I recalled that today as I mentioned it wrongly yesterday. It was not wrong. What I mentioned is that this if I said ja ending that is dakara then it is wrong, but I think I mentioned it right. I said udbhid dakara has become jakara in sandhi. So udbhid उद प्लस भिद उद प्लस भिद एंड देन दिस ज इज जनी प्रादुर्भावे धातु एंड दैट जन अन गोज अवे बट दिस डबल जकार द प्रायर जकार इज दकार विच हैज बिकम जकार इन संधि बिकॉज भिद धातु इज देयर. उत्पूर्वक भिद धातु उदपूर्वक भिद धातु दैट दकार इन दि भिद धातु हैज बिकम जकार. सो द वर्ड इज वॉट उद्भिज उद्भिज is the jayate. So ja there is jayate what udbhidya jayate. So it is explained in the current sutra udbhidya jayate having broken some things that which is born is called as udbhijya. So udbhijya is common to vrikshadi as well as swedaja insects not insects the krimi ityadi thereby swedaji is also included because kim udbhijya that akanksha is there. Having broken what? Having split what? It is born. So having split the jala or having split the prithvi is common to both. Therefore, avisheshat tena asya sangraha krataha. Tena kena udbhijya shabdena. Udbhijya iti shabdena asya svedajasya api sangraha krataha. That is the meaning. Nahi etavata chaturvidya hanirbhavati. Now when you say okay then why did you say there are four types? There are three only. In the third the fourth is included. So why would you say there are four? If that question is made, nahi etavata chaturvidya hanirbhavati. There is no issue with saying there are four types also. Why? Because thavara jangamatmakatvena ubhayor bhedasya durapahannavatvat. So not dura, durapahannavatvat. So what happens? How do you get the fourth as a separation? If you say the avishesha means there is something which is common, there is no difference. So you have said that there is no difference between vrikshadi and what you mean by swedaja, both are udbhijya. Then If there is no difference, then why do you make the fourth category? That would be wrong. No, says the Siddhanti, fourth category can be made by showing some difference. Just because there is no difference in one aspect, by yutpatti artha, avayava artha, it does not mean that there is no vishesha, there is no difference. There can be a difference shown as well. How is that? Sthavara jangama. Vrukshas are sthavara, but the svedaja are jangama. Those which are born from sweat, jala, they move around. Whereas vriksha cannot move around. So therefore, although both are udbhijja, still there is a difference in movability and immovability. Thereby you make a difference as vrikshadis are one category in udbhijja itself and svedaja is another category in udbhijja itself. So vishesha can also be shown, thereby sthavara jangama atmakatvena, atma there is swarupa. So sthavara janga swarupatvena ubhayoho bhedasya durapannavatvat. You cannot show that there is no vishesha. So Siddhanti is saying you cannot show that there is no vishesha, no avishesha in this aspect. In the aspect of both being udbhijja, there is avishesha, but there is vishesha also in the sense that there one is sthavara, other is jangama. Thereby what? Bhedasya durapavannavatvat. You cannot take away the bheda, says the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi. There is bheda possible in this aspect, therefore that bheda cannot be taken away. So bheda angikartavya ityartha. Durapavannavatvat, because of this hetu what? Bheda should be accepted. And the fourth category also should be accepted. Ataha, therefore, anishtadikarinam na chandraloka prapti. So all this discussion in this adhikarana, finally, where does it land us? Prasangika discussion has also come up. Therefore, Siddhanti says, Bhagavan Sadashiv Brahmendra says in the Vritti, do not get confused as to all this talk of various types of sharira. All this has come up in what? In the context of Purvapakshi making a aropa that it is not true that only punya karmis will get chandraloka vasa, everyone will get, meaning papis will also get. That is not true, because the fifth ahuti which was used as a hetu, which is possible only from chandraloka gati downwards, then only this fifth ahuti was possible, which causes the jala to take the jiva janma in a particular sharira, and therefore papis should also be included, and if papis are included, papis will also have chandraloka gachi. That is not true. Ataha anishtadikarinam na chandraloka praptihi. This swarga chandraloka ityadi will not be possible for anishtadikari, meaning papis, apitu ishtadikarinam evaiti siddham. But this chandraloka gamana is only for ishtapurtadi karini kari, who are punyakaris, those who have done punyakarma, for them alone the chandraloka prapti is there. Thereby this adhikarana is over. The next adhikarana is sabhavyapatti adhikaranam, which is introduced in the vritti by saying purvam tritiyam sthanam iti sthana shabdasya marga dvayopakrama samarthyat tritiya marga upalakshakatvam uktam. So you have used some kind of a logic by saying what? Tritiyam sthanam. Tritiyam sthanam is what? The adogati. Jayasvamriyasva iti tritiyam sthanam. That was said in the mantra, quoted as to what? Jayasvamriyasva iti eta tritiyam sthanam. Other than the two margas, devayana and pitriyana, there is third marga. What is that? That tritiya sthana. Marga is what? That sthana itself, being in that very loka after the dropping of the body, after the death of the sharira, mrityu, that itself is, that sthana is other than the two marga. Meaning there is no gamana in the two margas, but there is sthayi bhava. The very same loka one stays in. How? जायस्व मृयस्व, सच अ पापी विल बी बॉर्न अगेन एंड अगेन. वेरी शॉर्ट लिव्ड लाइफ स्पैन इज वॉट दैट पापी वुड गेट. एंड मल्टीपल टाइम्स ओवर एंड ओवर द पर्सन इज बॉर्न, नॉट यू कैन नॉट से पर्सन एनी मोर बिकॉज इज नॉट अ ह्यूमन बींग. सो द जीवा इज बॉर्न इन टू सच शरीरास विच आर माइन्यूट एंड दे आर बॉर्न अगेन एंड अगेन वेरी शॉर्ट लिव्ड विद अ वेरी शॉर्ट लिव्ड लाइफ स्पैन. कीट कृमि जन्म इत्यादि. सो देर बाय पूर्व तृतीय स्थानम इति स्थान शब्दस्य. व्हाट हैव यू सीन दैट स्थान शब्द स्थायी भाव स्टेइंग देयर इटसेल्फ विदाउट द ट्रैवल इनटू द टू मार्गास देवयान एंड पितृयान मार्गद्वय उपक्रम सामर्थ्यात्. स्थान शब्दस्य मार्गद्वय उपक्रम सामर्थ्य तृतीय मार्ग उपलक्षकत्व मुक्तम. सो कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग इट विद टू मार्गास मार्गद्वय उपक्रम सामर्थ्यात् बिकॉज ऑफ द सामर्थ्य ऑफ द टू मार्गास विच हैव बीन टॉक्ड अबाउट इन द उपक्रम. इन द उपक्रम टू इन द ओपनिंग स्टेटमेंट और द ओपनिंग ऑफ द सेक्शन टू मार्गास वेर डिस्कस देवयान पितृयान. सो दैट इज इन द उपक्रम. सो उपक्रम सामर्थ्य स्थान शब्द से तृतीय मार्ग उपलक्षकत्व. सो स्थान शब्द हैज कम अप लेटर कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग विद द अदर टू. सो अदर टू मार्गास बिकॉज तृतीय शब्द इज यूज. सो द फर्स्ट टू हैव गॉन बाय मार्गद्वय एंड द थर्ड विद द थर्ड तृतीय वॉट हैज बीन सेड द स्थान शब्द हैज बीन यूज. देयरफॉर स्थान शब्द विल बी कॉन्ट्रास्टेड अगेन विद द यूज ऑफ तृतीय शब्द विद द टू मार्गास विच हैव गॉन इन उपक्रम एंड देयर बाय मार्गद्वय उपक्रम सामर्थ्या स्थान शब्द से तृतीय मार्ग उपलक्षकत्व मुक्तम. So the sthana is the third marga, which is not really a travel into another loka, but travel within the same loka. It is like, you know, if you are taking a vacation, you are in the same state or city, that is also a vacation. But you will say, no, I was here itself. Did you go? So you say, you went to a different country or a different, state. So you will say, I was here. But where are you traveling? You are traveling, but you will say, I was here. No, I was roaming around here itself. So some other family in a summer vacation took their kids and they went somewhere else, some other state, went up northwards into Himalayas, whatever, you know. And this family stayed within. So where did you go? I stayed here itself. Yes, traveled a lot. Maybe traveled more than the others. Possible. You are local, so you travel a lot. But the other fellow has, with his family, has traveled a great distance, but not a lot. He's traveled, took a train or flight, whatever, but did not travel a lot there. There, a lot of exhaustion, stayed there, but saw only few specific places. But being here also, the family that stayed back in the same state could have visited a lot of places. Could have driven around or gone to some local places, come back and seen everything that there is to see here. Tourist spots. So all of that can be covered and multiple times there can be travel compared to the other family. So this is the situation of this Tritiya Sthana. Here itself, but so much of travel within, from one Sharira to other, yet another and so on. So Jayasva Mriyasva, that is possible. Thereby, Purva Pakshi says, Purvam Tritiyam Sthanam Iti Sthana Shabdasya Margadvaya Upakrama Samarchyat. Because in the opening, two words of Marga have been used. But this Thadhatu means what? Gati Nivrittav. So how can there be Gati? There is a Nivritti of Gati because Tha Gati Nivrittav, says the Dhatu Patha. Still, by Upakrama talking about two Margas, Sthana also is an indicatory of Marga itself. Thereby, Tritiya Shabda put together will give the sthana in contrast with the earlier two margas. The sthana shabda can be understood as tritiya marga upalakshakattvam. It is an upalakshana. Sthana stands for marga as well. Although it is gati nivritti, it is also gati. Gati nivritti meaning can be taken by not having gati unto other lokas. But within this loka itself there can be gati, that can be called by sthana also. न तथे, as we saw in the vacation example, न तथा इह भवति श्रुते हे सादृश्य लक्षकत्वम। देर बाय पूर्व पक्षी सेज नाउ यू टेक सच काइंड ऑफ अ लॉजिक एंड यू ट्राई टू अप्लाई इन द करंट सिनेरियो विच आई विल कोट। ही सेज इन दिस केस न तथा इह भवति। इन दिस केस सच काइंड ऑफ अ लॉजिक कैन नॉट बी एक्सटेंडेड। वाय श्रुते हे सादृश्य लक्षकत्वम इज नॉट पॉसिबल। दिस लॉजिक इज नॉट पॉसिबल बाय श्रुते हे सादृश्य लक्षकत्वम तत्र मानाभावात्। बिकॉज देर इज नो प्रमाण। मानाभावात् मीन्स प्रमाणाभावात् इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या इदम्। इट्स अ काउंटर एग्जाम्पल। वॉट इज द काउंटर एग्जाम्पल वी सी इन द सूत्र। बट पूर्व पक्षी इज टेकिंग द लॉजिक विच हेज बीन यूज इन द अर्लियर अधिकरण कैन नॉट बी यूज एल्सवेयर। दैट केस ही विल कोट एज टू सच लॉजिक कैन नॉट बी एक्सटेंडेड टू द अदर पार्ट। देर इज नो प्रमाण फॉर सच इंटरप्रिटेशन। यू हैड प्रमाण इन द अर्लियर अधिकरण विच इज वॉट मार्गद्वय उपक्रम सामर्थ्यम। दैट वॉज द प्रमाण। दैट वॉज द साधना यूज टू एस्टैब्लिश दिस काइंड ऑफ एन अनुमान विच इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन द काउंटर एग्जाम्पल दैट आई विल शो यू देर बाय प्रत्युदाहरण संगति। काउंटर एग्जाम्पल दैट इज द कनेक्शन विद द नेक्स्ट अधिकरण साभाव्यापत्तिकरण अधिकरण। तत्साभाव्यापत्तिरुपपत्ते भगवान सूत्रकार सेज तत्साभाव्यापत्ति। तत्साभाव्यापत्ति इज अ सिंगल वर्ड। उपपत्ते इज अ हेतु पंचमी। ड्यू टू उपपत्ति ड्यू टू टेनेबिलिटी पॉसिबिलिटी दैट इट इज टेनेबल लॉजिकली सो। एंड व्हाट इज तत्साभाव्यापत्ति। साभाव्य इज सादृश्य एंड तत् इज आकाश हियर। सो व्हाट इज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट हियर। द कॉन्टेक्स्ट इज द सेम गमन अधोगति एंड इट इज फॉर वैराग्य एज पर दिस सिद्धांती। व्हाट पूर्वपक्षी इज सेइंग इज दिस आकाश मीनिंग एल्सवेयर व्हाट इज सेड इज दैट द जर्नी ऑफ द जीवा। सो वी लुक एट द मंत्र इट विल बी ईजियर। So I'll explain that and then we'll go to the vritti proper, but I will take the vritti gata shruti quoted. So shruyate hi avaroha shruti. So avarohana meaning how does the jiva come to this loka. There is another shruti which talks about what athaitam evadhvanam punar nivartante yathetam akasham akashad vayum vayurbhutva धूमो भवति धूमो भूत्वा भ्रम भवत्यभ्रम भूत्वा मेघो भवति मेघो भूत्वा प्रवर्षति। सो सच जर्नी इज गिवन एज टू जीवा बिकम्स व्हाट। व्हाट इज द जर्नी। हाउ डज जीवा टेक द शरीरा। फाइनली वी हैव सीन द फिफ्थ आहुति काइंड ऑफ अ पंचाग्नि विद्या। नाउ अ सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ एन एक्सप्रेशन इज देयर विथ अनदर मंत्र एज टू हाउ इज जर्नी। व्हाट डज ही बिकम। सो देयर what is the exact rupa of this jiva, that kind of a question or a curiosity is answered there. Or you know the mantra says that, so one can be curious also other way around also as to oh this is what kind of a rupa is this that jiva would get when he is born in this sharira in this loka. He is not in this loka. There what will happen, the journey is atha etam avad punar nivartante. So one is born avad अथ एतम एव अध्वानम। अध्वानम देर इज दिस अधोगति नॉट अधोगति बट अवरोहण। अवरोहण फ्रॉम दि चंद्रलोक इत्यादि कमिंग डाउन टू दिस लोक दैट काइंड ऑफ पुनर्निवर्तन्ते। सो द जीवाज आर बॉर्न अगेन फ्रॉम अदर लोक इन टू दिस लोक। सो दैट इज दि अवरोहण। सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अवरोह श्रुति। अवरोहण श्रुति द जीवा हू इज coming down from another loka to this loka. So what is the journey? Yathetam. Yathetam we have seen earlier also. So yathetam, the way it has is described in this manner. How is that? Akasham akashad vayu. First he becomes what? Yathetam akasham. So jivaha punar nivartante. Katam bhutaha jivaha. In which form are these jivas? So akasham, first form is akasham, then akashad vayum, from Akashad, Akashad Vayum Vayur Bhutva. Having become Vayu, from Akasha, Vayu, and that having become Vayu, what? Vayur Bhutva Dhumo Bhoti. Having become Vayu from Akasha, then from first Akasha, then from Akasha, having become Vayu, and Vayu, having become Vayu, what? Vayur Bhutva Dhumo Bhoti. Then becomes Dhuma, smoke, literally. So then Dhumo Bhutva Abhram Bhoti. Having become Dhuma, what? Becomes Abhra, cloud. Then Abhram Bhutva Megho Bhavati. So Dhuma can also be taken as steam, you know, because Agni, some Agni kind of a thing was also seen earlier, because all these are Ahutis. So from Akasha Vayu, and then Vayu from that, you know, some kind of a smoke or steam, which becomes cloudy, and then from cloud rain. So some kind of, you know, we can have some kind of understanding which may not be correct, because otherwise the question won't come up. The question won't come up if it is completely explained to both the Purvapakshi and the Siddhanti. So the question of the Purvapakshi is, because he is having such ideas, Dhumo Bhutva Abhram Bhavati, the cloud, then Abhram Bhutva Megho, Abhram Bhutva, so Abhra is a particular formation there, and then the cloud, Megha. So after that, what? Then finally what? Abhram Bhutva Megho Bhavati, Megho Bhutva Pravarshati. So Akasha Vayu, then Dhuma, then Abhra, and then Megha, and then finally Varsha, Pravarshati. So this kind of a journey is talked about. Abhra also has some kind of a Megha idea, so we have to separate it by some kind of a additional meaning there, because Abhra and Megha have been separated. Abhra also has the meaning of Megha itself, but there may be some other there you can take a steam meaning perhaps. So you can say, you know, the cloud formation is not complete cloud, it has not become, but some kind of a steam formation coming together as a cloudy but not a cloud. So some difference can be made there by between Abhra and Megha. So Dhuma can be seen as some smoke, or you know, the vapor rising from the steam, something like that, you know. Some understanding can be there, which is at a very basic level, taking just a literal meaning. Now Purvapakshi says, and then Bhutva Pravarshati, then this is the journey. Jiva becomes finally what? Becomes Varsha, and then further there is a journey. Having become Varsha, what? Then the Panchagni Vidya says that what? There is an Ahuti in the form of what? This Varsha is also offered. Having offered this Varsha, then there is a crop kind of a Vrihi Ityadi Janma. Then in the form of Vrihi Ityadi, then Vrihi Ityadi has to be eaten by a Purusha. Then when it is eaten by the Purusha, the Jiva enters the Purusha. Having entered the Purusha, then what? There is more difficulty there. We'll see the difficulty. Just to give an idea there, the Jiva who has taken the form of Varsha at the end of this Pravarshati, Prakarshana Varsha, there is a lot of rain in which this Jiva is included, and he falls on Bhumi. Then in the form of a crop, this Jiva would enter that crop. Then Vri Ityadi, rice, etc. And then when this rice is eaten, rice can be eaten by a cow, it can be eaten by a bull, it can be eaten by goat, etc. It can be eaten by so many herbivorous animals. It can be eaten by a kid. It can be eaten by a by different gender, with both the genders. It can be eaten by a young kid, or it can be eaten by a very old man who won't have an opportunity to have stri sanyoga and give janma to a child, whereby the Jiva will have finally opportunity to take the Sharira, which is the Mukhya Sharira, where there will be Tadatme Sambandha. So where is the Jiva's journey, this Avarohana, going to end? It is going to end only when he enters a womb, or as a Udbhijya Ityadi, finally whatever is his destination, out of the four types of Janmas which have been discussed earlier. Out of the four types of Janmas, whichever is due in Prarabdha, there alone there is a Mukhya Janma. Everywhere else there is association. This is a Siddhanta. Association means the Jiva is just using the body of some other Jiva just to pass through and get to the culmination, the final destination. So somebody is traveling, you just hop in. दिस इज द सिद्धांति, सिद्धांति इज परस्पेक्टिव, बट पूर्व पक्षी सीज दैट दिस इज द मुख्य जन्म एंड द जीवा इज टेकिंग सो मेनी डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स एंड देयर बाय देन फाइनली देर इज अ जन्म, बट ऑल ऑफ दीज फाइनली देर इज अ जन्म इन टू अ शरीर विच इज ड्यू, बट ऑल दीज आर ऑल्सो ड्यू, मीनिंग ऑल दीज एसोसिएशन आर रियल जन्मास इन दोज पर्टिकुलर फॉर्म्स. दिस इज द पूर्व पक्षीज परस्पेक्टिव एंड देयर बाय आकाशा इज द फॉर्म ऑफ द जीवा, द फर्स्ट फॉर्म. सो जीव टेक्स द आकाशाज फॉर्म लिटरली. दिस इज वॉट द श्रुति इंटरप्रिटेशन, दिस इज वॉट इज द श्रुति इंटरप्रिटेशन मेड बाय द पूर्व पक्षी. देयर बाय आरोपा कम्स इन. सो तत् साभाव्यापत्ति मीन्स वॉट नाउ सादृश्य. सिद्धांति सेज न, इट इज नॉट दैट जीवा इज टेकिंग आकाशाज फॉर्म, वायु फॉर्म, अभ्रा फॉर्म, धूमा फॉर्म, अभ्रा फॉर्म, मेघा फॉर्म, वर्षा फॉर्म, एंड देन फर्दर ऑल्सो जर्नी इज देयर व्रीही फॉर्म. बट देन सिद्धांति सेइंग दैट फाइनली ऑल दिस जर्नी इज फॉर द प्रारब्ध ड्यू, वॉट एवर शरीर इज ड्यू इन प्रारब्ध, एंड फॉर दैट द लास्ट पंचम आहुति विच इज डिस्कस इन द अर्लियर सेक्शन और इन द पंचाग्नि विद्या, दैट इज द जन्म. सो टुवर्ड्स दैट जन्म द जर्नी कैन बी इन एनी विच वे. That journey does not mean that the jiva has taken such kind of a janma, akasha form, etc. It is similar to akasha. It is similar to vayu. Similar to that kind of a form which is comparable. It is not literally so. Because in the final janma also, if you look at it, that is possible only when there is a pumstri sanyoga. And since we are looking at what? We are actually looking at the journey from chandraloka or another loka. So it is not a papi's janma. Papi's janma has been in the same tritiya sthana, jayasva mriyasva. Therefore that jiva has not travelled at all, papi jiva. So punya jiva who has travelled, that punya jiva will usually not get this janma into other shariras. He would likely get the janma. I mean, just saying, likely janma, it is possible that tiryagadi, animal janma, etc. is possible. But then we are looking at a journey from the Swargaloka to the Bhuloka. So in Bhuloka, Vruksha Janma or Tiryag Janma is not possible, is not the claim, but that may be the main Janma, Andaja or Jarayuja. So Jarayuja or Andaja kind of Janma, even Andaja, if at all it is that Andaja Janma or Samadhar Janma, but Pumstri Sanyoga is there because otherwise there is no point of that jiva being in the vrihi form, having taken the association with vrihi ityadi. So vrihi ityadi bhava tells you that it has to be eaten to be born into another sharira through the bija from the pum to the stri. Therefore very likely that it will be jarayuja janma, not even andaja. So this is just an inquiry into what is the situation there. We have hetus there as to the jiva has done lot of punya, so swarga bhoga is there. Now from the swarga, very unlikely that one would get a prani janma immediately or a stavara janma, vruksha janma. It is more likely that one would get not even an andaja janma, bird janma, but a human janma. So with that consideration, what should you see? Now you should see that a young male should have consumed the rice, etc., vrihi ityadi, where this jiva is associated, and meaning basically who is going to be the child's father, this jiva's father now. That kind of a situation should arise where the purusha who is vivahita and is wanting a child, is trying to get a child, that kind of an age should be there, that kind of a bhavana should be there, and then this purusha should have consumed vrihadi where this to be born jiva is associated, and then such purusha has stri sanyoga which is wife, and then she carries his child, and then finally jarayuja, this putra putri rupena, this jiva is born. This is the journey विच इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू और इंटेंडेड टू बी कन्वेड बाय द श्रुति इन ऑल दिस. सो नाउ वॉट काइंड ऑफ अ रेरिटी वुड इट बी फॉर दैट पुरुषा टू ईट इन दैट पर्टिकुलर एज वेन एक्सपेक्टिंग टू गिव टू एक्सपांड हिज फैमिली एंड देयर बाय ही कंज्यूम्स दिस व्रीहादि एंड देन दैट व्रीहादि इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू बीजा विच इज गिवन एज अ फिफ्थ आहुति टू हिज वाइफ एंड देन शी कैरीज हिज चाइल्ड एंड गिव्स जन्म. हाउ रेयर वुड इट बी. सो नाउ इफ यू से इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट नाउ लुक एट द फॉलोइंग सूत्रास तत् साभावयापत्तिर उपपत्ते हे. सो नाउ दिस आकाश इत्यादि रूप विच इज डिस्कस्ड इन दिस अथेतम इत्यादि मंत्र पूर्व पक्षी सेज दीज आर आकाश रूप दैट जीवा गेट्स वायु रूप इत्यादि लिटरली सो. वेर एज दिस सिद्धांति भगवान सूत्रकार सेज नॉट सो साभाव्यापत्ति इट इज पॉसिबल विथ अ सिमिलरिटी ऑफ फॉर्म सटल लाइक आकाश अ सिमिलर फॉर्म ऑफ वायु सच काइंड ऑफ अ डिस्क्रिप्शन इज गिवन बाय द श्रुति व्हेन इट यूजेस आकाश वायु इत्यादि शब्द. दिस इज व्हाट द वाय उपपत्ते बिकॉज दैट इज टेनेबल एंड हाउ सो दैट विल सी इन द वृत्ति. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे भवति श्रुतेः मुख्यत्व सिद्धिः सिद्धान्ते गौणत्व सिद्धिरिति फलभेदः. व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन पूर्वपक्षी एंड सिद्धांतिस पर्सपेक्टिव. पूर्वपक्षी टेक्स द वर्ड्स इन दैट मंत्र लिटरली मुख्य मीनिंग वेर एज सिद्धांति सेज दे आर गौण देर इज सादृश्य बट देर इज नो लिटरली आकाश भाव और वायु भाव. दैट इज ए फलभेद. पूर्व इष्टाधिकारिण अवरोहंती इत्युक्तम. सो व्हाट हैज बीन सेड अर्लियर द इष्टाधिकारी इष्टपूर्त कर्मकारीज पुण्यकारीज आर गोइंग टू टेक जन्म इन दिस लोक आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ पुण्य इन द स्वर्गलोक चंद्रलोक. सो अवरोह अवरोहण इज देयर अवरोहंती दे हैव जर्नी फ्रॉम अनदर लोक टू दिस लोक. अत्र तेषां अवरोह प्रकार चिंचते. व्हाट इज द मैनर इन विच दे टेक जन्म हियर व्हाट इज देयर जर्नी दैट इज बीइंग इन्क्वायर्ड इनटू. श्रूयते ही अवरोह श्रुति. व्हाट इज द अवरोह श्रुति विच इज सीन हर्ड. अथ एतम एव आध्वानं पुनर्निवर्तन्ते यथेतम आकाशम आकाशाद् वायुं वायुर्भूत्वा धूमो भवति धूमो भूत्वा ब्रह्म भवति ब्रह्म भूत्वा मेघो भवति मेघो भूत्वा प्रवर्षति इति. यू हैव सीन द मीनिंग सो आई विल नॉट रिविजिट. सो जीवास हैव जन्म अवरोण टेकिंग दीज वेरियस फॉर्म्स वन आफ्टर द अदर इन सीक्वेंस फाइनली बिकमिंग वर्षा एंड फॉलिंग ऑन टू दि भूलोक. तत्र किं स्वर्गाद अवरोहन्तः जीवाः दि जीवास हू आर हैविंग अवरोण फ्रॉम स्वर्ग इन दैट मंत्र आकाशादि स्वरूपं प्रतिपद्यन्ते. जीवाः आकाशादि स्वरूपं प्रतिपद्यन्ते. डू दे अटेन जीवास डू दे अटेन आकाश वायु इत्यादि रूपास लिटरली उतः तत्साम्यम इति विषये. और इज इट सादृश्य सिमिलरिटी टू आकाश वायु इत्यादि सम काइंड ऑफ अ सिमिलर फॉर्म नॉट एग्जैक्टली आकाश और वायु. व्हेन सच काइंड ऑफ अ डाउट इज रेज्ड और कम्स टू द माइंड देन आकाश आदि स्वरूप इति पूर्वपक्ष. पूर्वपक्ष इट इज लिटरली ही सेज दैट आकाश वायु इत्यादि फॉर्म्स आर टेकन बाय जीवास. सिद्धांति से सिद्धांतस्तु जीवानां तैः आकाशादिभिः साभाव्यापत्तिः. साभाव्यापत्ति आकाशादिभिः जीवास व्हाट डू जीवानां तैः व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ फॉर्म डज दिस डू दिस जीवास हैव. सो दे हैव फॉर्म सिमिलर टू आकाशादि. आकाशादिः साभाव्यापत्ति. व्हाट इज मीनिंग ऑफ साभाव्यापत्ति. समानः भावः. भाव मीन्स रूपम. समान सिमिलर भाव रूप मीनिंग सिमिलर फॉर्म. येषां ते स्वभाव. सो दोज हु हैव सिमिलर फॉर्म टू आकाश आदि दोज जीवाज आर कॉल्ड एज स्वभाव. येषां ते स्वभाव दे आर कॉल्ड एज स्वभाव जीवा. तद्भाव मीनिंग स्वभाव भाव भावस्य भाव और स्वभावानां भाव इज स्वभाव्यम. ष्यञ्च प्रत्यय इज एडेड इन दि तस्य भाव काइंड ऑफ अ मीनिंग. तद्धित स्वभाव्यम meaning what sadrishyam. so sabhavyam is equal to sadrishyam similarity. so jivas have similarity with akashadi akashavayu. this is the siddhanta. tasya apatti prapti. so sadrishyam similarity attain the similarity. so apatti means prapti. and what is prapti? attainment. attainment of what? attainment. so what is the tat sabhavyapatti? the meaning is प्राप्ति अटेनमेंट ऑफ साभाव्य सादृश्यम सिमिलैरिटी विथ तत् मीनिंग विथ तई ही तई विथ दोज मीनिंग विथ आकाश इत्यादि. सो दैट इज द समास विग्रह एक्सप्लेनेशन. कुतः व्हाय डू यू इंटरप्रेट सो आस्क द पूर्वपक्षी. कस्मात् कारणात् उपपत्ते है ड्यू टू टेनेबिलिटी. व्हाट इज दैट चंद्रलोकम गतानाम अनुशायिनाम प्रवृत्त फल कर्म क्षय दर्शन जनित शोकाग्निना दह्यमानम इदम शरीरम करकादिवद विलीयमानम आकाश समम भवति इति एतद् उपपद्यते. सो देयर इज एन उपपत्ति उपपत्ते है ड्यू टू उपपत्ति ही. सो देयर सिद्धांती सेज वाई सो इज बिकॉज द जीवा हु हैज हैड स्वर्गलोकवास जीवास मल्टीपल प्लूरल. सो जीवास हु हैव हैड स्वर्गलोकवास वॉट आर दे गोइंग टू वॉट इज देयर अनुभवा देयर सुख मोर सुख देन it is there in this loka, long lasting and in high intensity. So more sukha and multiple times of sukha here and very less dukkha if at all and a long long stay. This is what is the anubhava of the jivas who are in swargaloka chandraloka. Now at the end, because karma phala will end finally. And when the karma phala ends, what will happen? Suddenly there is no marana ityadi. What will happen? The body, there is no janma in swarga. What happens finally, just like in the dream, you are already in a particular body. What is that particular body in swapna? It can be a grown body, it can be a kid's body, it can be an old person's body. Whatever is the sharira, there we don't have a journey from, in each dream we don't have a journey from being born. Just like you have in Jagratavastha, we don't have that in Swapnavastha. In Swapnavastha we already are into a particular, associated with a particular aged body. And that can be the same age that we are in Jagratavastha, it can be a different one also, whatever it is. But there is no janma ityadi. Similarly, in Swarga, there is an association with a young body really, which does not age, and there is no janma ityadi and no dukkha of the childhood, etc. There is a young, healthy body with which we are associated, and suddenly, without marana and disease, etc., suddenly this body is going to vanish, and there is travel back home into this bhuloka. So, that being the case, what is being argued by the Siddhanti is that upapatte, what is the tenability? Chandralokam gatanam anushayinam. Anushayis are those who have balanced karma, we have seen. So shesha karma vantaha jivanam anushayinam, those who have karma left, sanchita karma, which is going to be carved into a prarabdha for another janma, they have gone to Chandraloka, but then what will happen? प्रवृत्त फल कर्म क्षय दर्शन जनित शोकाग्निना. दिस कर्म इज गोइंग टू एंड. ऑब्वियसली द कर्म विच लेड टू द फला इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्वर्गलोक वासा, दैट इज गोइंग टू कम टू एन एंड. एंड इफ इट हैज कम टू द एंड, व्हाट विल हैपन देन? प्रवृत्तम फलम येषाम कर्मणाम, दोज कर्मज विच हैव लेड टू द प्रवृत्त स्वर्ग सुख फला, तेषां कर्मणां क्षयस्य दर्शनेन, दैट कर्म इज कमिंग टू एन एंड. बिकॉज वन वुड नो दैट ओ माय कर्म इज बीइंग एग्जॉस्टेड विच हैज लेड टू दिस स्वर्ग फल, इट इज कमिंग टू एन एंड. सो नाउ आल बी लीविंग दिस स्वर्ग लोक. ऑल्दो देर इज नो मरण, मीनिंग ओल्ड एज, जरा व्याधि इत्यादि, still what will happen? There is dukkha which will be there towards the end of the karma which is led to, earned karma which has led to swarga phala. When it is thinning down, watering down, coming to an end, then one would feel dukkha. Oh, the swarga vasa is going to be over. It is like, you know, you already know that you are going to leave, you have gone to a the example in the vacation itself, let's say, gone to the Himalayas for vacation, say 3 week vacation, summer vacation with kids, a long, long trip. Kids are happy, spouse is happy, we are happy, if all this is there, but then we know only 3 days left, kids are complaining, only 3 days left, again, school, etc. Spouse is complaining, I have to go back home, whatever, you know, Gruha Karya or whatever, trouble with the office, etc. We have the same feeling. So, Dukkha is there, even in that Sukha as to, oh, it is going to come to an end in only three days. Or, you know, parting with loved ones, you know that you are meeting a friend after a long time, but then you know the friend is going to leave. So, there is Dukkha, even while the Sukha of meeting loved ones is there. Because it is going to come to an end. And we know this. Similarly, this Swargavasi Jivas, these Swargavasi Jivas will also have a feeling, oh, Pravrutta Phala Karma is attaining Shaya. Therefore, Phala will also go away. And therefore, due to that darshan, what? Tesham Karmanam Kshayasya Darshanena Janitaha Yaha Shoka. The Shoka, grief which is born out of that darshana of depletion of karma which has led to Swarga Phala. Then what? That Shoka itself was Shoka Rupa Agni Na. Shoka Eva Agni. What is that Agni? Shoka Rupa Agni. Madhyama Padalopi Samasa can be read. Shoka Rupa Agni Na. Dayamanam Idam Shariram. This Sharira is going to be burnt. Which Sharira? Swargaloka Prapta Sharira. That Sharira is going to be burnt by this Dukkha Agni. And thereby what will happen? Shoka Agni. And thereby Karakadi Vat Viliyamanam. This Sharira is going to melt. Is going to melt like what? Karaka. So there, what happens is that Karaka is basically, you can take it as, you know, in Hindi they call as ole, or, you know, some kind of an ice formation. So if the, imagine the Sukha, which is Prapta as a result of Karma, being Anubhuta in a particular Sharira, consider that Sharira to be like ice. Comparison is given, it is, you know, basically what hardened water, frozen water, that water is going to melt, is going to melt because the Sharira vanishes. How will it vanish? So a simile is given, like the ice becomes water and then evaporates. This is how the Sharira is going to vanish. So Karakadi Vat, like ice is going to be melted by heat and then finally vaporized and it is going to vanish. Karakadivat Viliyamanam, and you know, see the Sharira melting away. That kind of a, for Vairagya, it is this kind of a explanation is given. Karakadivat Viliyamanam Akasha Samam, and then what? Vanishing into what? Into Akasha form. Like space, it is comparable. That is the Samata or Samanabhava Sadrushya and Sabhavyapattihi. So Karakadivat Viliyamanam Akasha Samam Bhavati Iti Etad Upapadyate. It becomes similar to Akasha, not Akasha itself. The Sharira vanishes into thin air. So the Jiva is was associated with that Sharira which has vanished, which has become Akasha Sama now. So this Jiva is still associated with that Sharira, which is now changed into a particular form. Just like a child's Sharira grows up into a Yavana Sharira. It's a different Sharira altogether. The same Jiva is associated without a break. Similarly, the same Jiva sees is Karakavat Sharira melting away and Akashavat Sharira association still remains. He is still associated. He sees that, oh, my Sharira itself is being transformed into something like Akasha, something like Vayu, Abhra, Ityadi. So, he sees that journey, but there is no exact Akasha or Vayu Sambandha. Iti etar upapadyate nahi anyasya anya bhava mukhya upapadyate. Mukhya upapadyate. It is not possible that Anya will take Anya Bhava. Meaning one who is not Akasha cannot become Akasha. One who is not Vayu cannot become Vayu. So Anyasya Anya Bhava Mukhya na upapadyate. It is not possible in the Mukhya meaning. It has to be in the Gauna meaning. Tasmat Sadrisham Yav Pratipadyante Jivaha. Jivaha, who are the Jivaha? Avarohanta Jiva. Swargad Avarohantaha Jivaha. Sadrishyamiyo pratipadyante natu akasham ityadi mukhya bhava. So mukhya bhava na pratipadyante, but sadrishyamiyo pratipadyante iti siddham. This is the idea as to establishment using logic as to since one cannot really become the other, the association changing, association not changing, sharira changing, that changing is similar to akasha, similar to vayu, etc. And then finally being born in this bhuloka, which is the ultimate goal in this prarabdha of this anushayi jiva or multiple jiva. Iti siddham, this is the little complex in terms of the words used and the analysis, therefore longer sutra interpretation. We'll see more in the next part. आम्नायन्तिक संसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम अपूर्णम आत्म ज्योतिर उपासमहे. नमस्ते, धन्यवाद.
धन्यवाद.